Welcome back. So, Majid, tomorrow it's going to be the biggest match of this tournament for Pakistan because, you know, it's a do-and-die match. Whoever wins this will qualify for the final, and it's Pakistan versus Bangladesh. So, what changes do you recommend Pakistan will have? They will have a training session today at the ICC Academy, and maybe, you know, they'll try out something different. But, you know, in the final stages of the tournament, do you think we will actually go in with a major change tomorrow? Someone like Shaan Masood coming in maybe for Fakhar Zaman, or maybe Junaid Khan finally coming into the team in place of Amir or Hasan Ali, or whatever that could have been. What do you think about that?
It's sad to listen to this comment that the biggest match we have is against Bangladesh now.
Absolutely.
It is very sad, but Bangladesh have been playing well. Credit goes to them. What Pakistan needs to do right now is think differently. Whatever they're doing, whatever they're planning, whatever their contingency plans are, everything is failing. They don't have a game plan. Even if they have it, it's falling apart. And when it falls apart, they don't know what to do. And that is where the inexperience plays in. Shoaib Malik, again, the prime example of how to handle the pressure in crunch situations. He's been doing it throughout the tournament. Pakistan need to realize that they need to make some drastic changes or come up with a new strategy.
Yeah.
They need to chase. They might, because we are very bad at chasing and we always in the toss and bat first.
Yeah.
So they might go for chasing. There are other plans, like, again, as you mentioned, Shaan Masood, he hasn't been tested in this tournament and he's a very good player in domestic cricket, and our domestic pitches are same as UAE.
Yeah.
There is no turn, no swing, no bounce. So he might be a good option. And I would like to bring in Azhar Ali here, because Azhar Ali is a cool and calm operator of the order. And Fakhar Zaman needs that calming presence with him.
Someone like Shaan Masood might fit
and
that.
Shaan Masood has, even though he might not be a world-class opener right now, but he's our best choice because we only have three openers. So Fakhar Zaman, and he has played with the likes of Yunus Khan and Misbah Ulhaq. So he has a lot of experience on his side as compared to Imam Ulhaq.
Yeah.
No, he's not the best, but as compared to Imam, he has a lot of experience and he can bring in that. And his role should be very clear from the start that he needs to support Fakhar. Because once Fakhar gets going, the match would be finished right then and there. Pakistan would win the match because he is that kind of a player.
Yeah.
Someone needs to go and support him. Even if they play Imam, they need to tell him, you're not playing as an opener, you're playing as a partner with Fakhar Zaman. You need to give him the confidence. If he's not able to connect, if he's not able to rotate the strike, you need to do that for him until and unless he finds his mid-ash touch.
Yeah.
And once he finds that, the match will be over right there and then. Otherwise, in the bowling department, we have five pacers, one spinner. We have no option other than to play at least two or three seamers. Two would be a very big risk if they play two seamers and they rely on Malik to bowl the 10 overs, then they bring in Haris Sohail. I personally would like to see that if they go with Malik, Haris Sohail, Shadab and two seamers. Because on these tracks, you can't play with pace. Pace would always get bashed and thrashed in these conditions.
So do you think that, you know, Pakistan should actually replace Nawaz with Haris Sohail and not Asif Ali with Haris Sohail?
I personally feel that Nawaz should be there. He gives you an extra bowling option, an extra spin bowling option.
Yeah.
So playing him over Fahim is always the right choice for me in the UAE conditions at least.
Yeah.
When we go to the World Cup, Fahim would be a better option. But right now here, Mohammad Nawaz is the best pick. I would throw out Asif Ali because he's not doing what he's supposed to do, and we can't risk it against Bangladesh. We can't risk giving him another chance of going out and doing what we are told that he does best, plays big shots.
Yeah.
So we can't risk it against Bangladesh. It's a do or die situation. The best thing is play Shaan Masood top of the order with Fakhar Zaman and tell him that your role is to support Fakhar. Take Asif Ali out, bring Haris Sohail in. He gives you an extra option of bowling. And as far as Mohammad Amir is concerned, finally, I would say that we should take Mohammad Amir out of the equation. We should take him out of the match and bring Junaid Khan in, because Junaid Khan has been itching in this tournament. Junaid Khan has been itching for a long time now for a chance, and this chance may give him that energy to just come and bowl Bangladesh out of their minds. That is what we need right now. We need one player to just energize all of the team.
Yeah.
And Junaid Khan might be that player. Shaan Masood might be that player, although my hopes are on Junaid Khan, not Shaan Masood.
Mm-hmm, yeah.
Or Haris Sohail maybe. But you need to experiment now, because that is, Bangladesh knows all about you now.
Yeah.
Bangladesh knows what you're lacking, confidence, batting, everything. They know everything about you. You need to come up with a new strategy or some surprise package.
Yeah, because we have seen this in the past as well, that, you know, players who are sitting outside, and once they come in with a lot more fresher mind, you know, they actually perform better than the ones who are actually playing in the game are tired and exhausted as well.
Yesterday, I was discussing it with someone that Pakistan team right now, they have a lot of young players. But again, complacency to some extent has moved into the team. Because Hassan Ali knows he's going to play. He's a world-class bowler. We've told them that.
Yeah.
We know, Amir knows that I'll play. All the players are now comfortable in their positions. And the squad that we selected, which was a very big flop, because we were thinking that the young guns will again blow everyone out. The combination in the squad that we have doesn't allow us to do anything different.
Yeah, it's a very one-dimensional squad.
It's a very one-dimensional squad. Five pacers in UAE conditions. And even with if England would bring in five pacers, I would be fine. Yeah, England doesn't understand.
I think you're
UAE
not calculating Fahim Ashraf in this, because if Fahim, he actually includes in the,
yes, he's the sixth pacer with you.
Yeah.
What were you thinking? What were you planning? And even if you have sent Harish Sohail, let him play. Let him go in there, play at the number four position. Bring Malik down. Bring Sarfaraz up the order in the fifth number. Or you can switch Sarfaraz and Malik's positions on fifth and sixth number. Although I would prefer that Malik plays at the number five role and Sarfaraz comes in later, because Malik has to play a finisher's role. You can't expect him to go out in the 10th over or the 15th over and play till the 50th over, because you can't rely on one batsman to do everything for you. You have 11 players. You need to think of a new strategy where everyone pitches in, and everyone needs to pitch in now, because this is, again, we're cornered. We need to come up with something different, something exceptional, basically, to beat Bangladesh. And even if we beat them by a very low margin, or if it becomes a crunch match, Pakistan will not gain that confidence that they need to beat India, which have beaten them convincingly
twice
in the last two matches.
Yeah.
So Pakistan need to beat Bangladesh by a very good margin. They need to run all over them, roll over all over them. Otherwise, even if we make it to the final, India would not be an easy opponent, and it might be a hat-trick of defeats in the Asia Cup. So let's hope that they come out with their A game.
So last few questions. Do you think that Pakistan, if they will win the toss, they should bat first tomorrow or bowl first tomorrow?
Depends.
Mind you that, you know, we are playing in Abu Dhabi and not in Sharjah.
Depends on the team combination. If they are going in with Harish Sohail, and if they exclude Asif and the team combination that I would prefer, if they are going in with that, they can easily chase a target, because Fakhar Zaman going, even Imam or Shan Masood, whoever it is, Babar Azam gives you a good 40 odd 50 runs. He's been quite consistent. So Harish Sohail brings in that extra edge of batting and bowling. So they should go for chasing as well if they lose the toss. But they should have both plans ready. They've looked all over the place in this tournament. They need to come up with something extremely, completely exceptional to beat Bangladesh, because Bangladesh right now are not looking an easy side to beat.
Thank you so much, Majid. And that's it from us today. We will discuss more about this match tomorrow. Till then, Allah Hafiz.